Hi. In the previous lecture, we derived a number of equations for compressible flow. In this video, we will use them to tackle problems concerning the flow in supersonic nozzles. We have found the second form of the isentropic relations using the energy equation with the velocity zero at a certain point upstream. Let's call this point station zero. The temperature and pressure in station zero, so where the velocity is zero, are called the total temperature and the total pressure. These equations all apply to compressible flow. When do we actually call a flow compressible? Let us look at the equation for the density ratio. Rho 0 divided by rho 1 is 1 plus gamma minus 1 divided by 2 times m1 squared to the power 1 over gamma minus 1. And if we want to have the ratio the other way around, so rho over rho 0, we can write the equation like this. Mind the minus in the exponent. This equation is valid when we speed up the flow from rest to a certain Mach number. At this slide, you see the line that represents this equation. For a density ratio of 0.95, meaning there is a difference in density of 5%, the Mach number is 0.3. And this is the boundary that in aeronautical engineering has been set for compressibility. We assume that a flow is incompressible when the Mach number is lower than 0.3, so when the change in density is less than 5%. Let's look at a schematic of a supersonic wind tunnel. We have a reservoir with air under high pressure and temperature. And when we open a valve, the air will speed up and flow through a converging channel until it reaches the point with the smallest area, which we call the throat. And in the throat, the Mach number is 1. To get a supersonic situation in the test section, we need a diverging channel after the throat. Intuitively, you would think that we need to further decrease the area of the channel to get to a higher Mach number. This is not the case. So what is happening? Let us concentrate for a moment on the continuity equation for compressible flow. Rho AV is constant. And this can also be written as the natural log of rho plus the natural log of A plus the natural log of V is equal to the natural log of a constant. And when we differentiate this equation, we get d rho over rho plus dA over A plus dV over V equals zero. Now we enter the Euler equation, dP is minus rho V dV, or rho is minus dP over V dV. If we insert this in the other equation, we find minus d rho V dV divided by dP plus dA over A plus dV over V equals zero. Now earlier we found that dP over d rho is equal to the speed of sound A squared. So we have minus V dV over A squared plus dA over A plus dV over V equals zero. And this can be written as dA over A equals V dV over A squared minus dV over V. Now, if we multiply the numerator and the denominator of the first term on the right-hand side with V, we have dA over A equals V squared dV over A squared times V minus dV over V. We see a known combination of V and A, namely the Mach number. So finally, we get dA over A equals m squared minus 1 times dV over V. And this is called the area velocity relation. Now what does it say? There are three cases to consider. M smaller than 1, m greater than 1, and m equal 1. First of all, suppose the Mach number is smaller than 1. Then, when the speed should increase, dV is positive. M squared minus 1 is negative, so dA should be negative. The area of the channel should decrease to increase the flow speed. This is just as we thought. And now case B. The Mach number is higher than 1. Now m squared minus 1 is positive, so to further increase the speed, also the area of the channel should increase. The flow should be given space to expand. And finally, a difficult one. Suppose the flow is sonic, so m is 1. Let us rewrite the equation dV over V equals 1 divided by m squared minus 1 times dA over A. Now, if m is 1, we have dV over V equals 1 divided by 0 times dA over A. At first glance, this would mean dV over V is infinite. But this cannot be true on a physical basis, since the change in velocity cannot be infinitely high. Secondly, the velocity is not zero, but sonic. Then there is no other possibility than that for a finite dV over V, dA over A should be zero. Then we have zero divided by zero, and this is finite. So dA over A is zero, and this can only be in the throat. So when we have a supersonic flow in the test section, the Mach number in the throat is 1. This next slide shows the development in the flow properties as the air flows through the channel. All properties in the throat are denoted with a star, so P star, rho star, T star, and so on. As the Mach number increases, the pressure, temperature, and density decrease. So how do we use the isentropic relations, the energy equation and the equation of state to solve problems? Check out the next video.